So we've had a pretty good journey, her and I.
A dog owner who will do anything for her beloved pet in pain.
I was scared. I didn't know what to do or what I could do for her.
Tonight, a Minnesota medical breakthrough. It may save Roxy's life, and humans could be next.
This could be the big type of breakthrough that people have been waiting for.
Researchers at the University of Minnesota are developing new treatments for pets with brain tumors. Thanks to that clinical trial, they are now learning the same technique is working to eliminate cancerous cells in people with brain tumors too. Katherine Johnson explains how it works.
Meet Roxy.
It is unconditional love.
A 12-year-old boxer.
They don't care if you're rich or you're poor.
With the energy of a puppy.
They just love you for you.
But she hasn't always been like this.
They're shaking in there on the floor, and you just don't know what to do.
6 months ago, Roxy was diagnosed with glioblastoma, the deadliest and most common type of brain cancer.
Here we go, Roxy.
Her owner, Chris Schmidt, was told she'd only survive 1 month.
Sit. Roxy, sit. Sit down. Good girl.
And then Schmidt found Dr. Liz Pluhar at the University of Minnesota.
We're doing something here that they're not doing anywhere else.
Roxy is one of 100 dogs Dr. Pluhar is treating for brain cancer, using a technique that doesn't involve toxic therapies like chemotherapy and radiation.
The chemotherapy and the radiation makes you feel bad. You're tired, you just don't feel well.
This is a vaccine.
All right, here we go, side two.
Designed to help the immune system destroy remaining cancer cells after the tumor is surgically removed.
You didn't even know I was back there.
It's a way of using your own body and what your own body can do, stimulating it to attack these tumor cells.
And it's yielding results.
Good. Girl, that's perfect.
Great.
No issues.
No more cancer cells either after just 3 treatments.
They act like there's nothing wrong with them at all. There's no side effects of the treatments, and they have a very good quality of life.
Dr. Pluhar says before the vaccine, dogs like Roxy were only living 1 month after diagnosis. With the treatment, it can be more than a year. And you know what they say, 1 year in dog years.
Does that translate to 7 years in people? That would be huge. I mean, that would be unheard of.
Tumors in dogs and people are often nearly clinically identical, meaning this treatment could work for both. Because of results like Roxy's, researchers are now undergoing the same clinical trial on people patients at the university's medical school.
It's kind of like I've given them hope where they didn't have any before, and it's a fantastic feeling, and this could be the big type of breakthrough that people have been waiting for.
It's been life-saving, not just for Roxy, but for other people that she can help. And now this will be her legacy. This will be something that I can always remember and be proud of for her.
There is little to no cost to the dog owner for going through the trial, and researchers are always looking for more applicants to better develop that vaccine into hopefully one day a cure. To get involved, visit our website, kstp.com.
She looks like such a nice dog. Now, you said they're studying brain cancer specifically here. Is there any possibility for this working for other cancers?
Absolutely, and other breeds of dogs. Interestingly enough, boxers are more susceptible to getting brain cancer, and golden retrievers get lymphoma. So that's the next study. The university just got a $1 million grant to start looking into that. This research is expanding rapidly.
Dogs and people, I think, very excited to see how this goes. Katherine, thanks so much.